Excuse me. Okay. So, did some manly things today. Very manly. At least I believe so. A lot of yard work. That's why I was all sweaty and probably dirty and stuff. But I did something that everybody should do. Once a year, at least once a year, maybe it's more often than that, but I think for me it's been once a year, is to check the air in your spare tires. Now, I've been doing this every year for pretty much forever, I guess, since I was 16. So, the great thing is that on the van and the truck, every time I do it, the pressures are just fine. So what I do is I clean the tires off really well because dirt and sand accumulate around the bead and around your valve and things like that. You want to get that cleaned off so it doesn't cause a problem when you actually need to use your spare tire. Hopefully you won't. So put a reminder in your Outlook calendar. I got dust in my throat. Put a reminder in your Outlook calendar and you should be good to go. Also, while I was weed whacking today, right around the edges of the house, the ground wire for our cable television got hooked into the weed whacker for the second time in this month and totally ripped. Well, I didn't quite rip it out of the ground, but I got really tired of that. So I cut that ground and rerouted it over to the house ground. And now it's tucked up out of the way. And really, it's in a much, much better place because previously it looked like they just shoved the wire deep down into the ground, and that seemed kind of odd to me. So hopefully, I know it's better now. So I had some long cable, not cable, I had some wires that I had to strip, about 15 feet of it, but that's okay. I had plenty of it. You should always have plenty of Romex around the house. Mark, is that the name for it, Romex? I think so. Anyway, so now that I'm done with the guy stuff, I'm going to do the non-guy stuff and show you my kick-ass iris flowers. So, here we go. We got a lot of the standard flowers. A lot of the standard, I guess they call them American Classic. I think that's what those are. And then there's some around here. Got some of these ruffled ones. And these are, I don't know, I just think these are the best ever. They're kind of got some browns and some yellows, and they just look awesome. Really like those. So this is my front flower garden and some clematis. What I'm trying to do is just make a nice little ground cover area here, and that's filling out pretty nicely. And then the rest of it, just this area to the by the side of the driveway, I'm really just trying to make it just full, just pack it full of all kinds of stuff. So these things that I always forget the name of are getting ready to bloom. We have some kind of red ones back here, and I'm going to go around to the back and show you what I have around back. Okay, now around to the back of the house. These were in this flower garden I'm going to show you was in the previous video where I showed you my chair that I built. There you go. So, these are nice. These are yellow and white. I don't know why I'm telling you the colors. You can see the colors. But these have got just an amazing color on them. And some more ruffled ones that are just really nice. I'm going to have to ask my mom for some more with yellow. She's the one that buys them out of magazines and stuff. And she gives us her splittings or when you divide them up for once a year. Got some lupine that came out this year. And my favorite, some California poppies, which I just have to get more of those. And then this may or may not be a weed, but sometimes if you just let things grow, you'll find out that it's not a weed. And some daisies and stuff. I don't really know the names of everything, but that's what we got in there. So this year we're doing something different. I hope this isn't too shaky. I haven't eaten much today, so I'm kind of shaky. So this year we decided to put our tomato plants in a more advantageous area where there's a lot more sun than in our actual garden. So you can see the cages. And I learned something new this year that when you buy your tomato plant and it's like say 12 inches tall, lay it down sideways so the root of the ball, root ball, whatever, the roots are actually right here. And then I spread it, the stem over here, cut off all the limbs and spread it over here and just angled this part up and buried it. And apparently that's the way that professionals do it. Tons and tons of lettuce and spinach. The spinach is starting to go to seed, but that's okay. You got plenty of spinach. So we got some two Romas, a couple of beefsteak tomatoes, and some cherry tomatoes. And then this crazy contraption. I spent $20 on this. What a complete waste. Because I couldn't find any more cages. I've had these cages for a long time, but I only have 5 of them. I need like 6 of them. For some reason, I couldn't find them anywhere. Everybody said, nope, we don't have them. Not the full size. So that really sucked. All right, let's hop back to the garden. So I planted a couple peach trees this year. This one's fighting off some kind of fungus. Once we transplanted, all of a sudden I got some fungus, so I've been spraying that, trying to get that to come around. That's a... Oh, shoot. That's going to be a white... I think that's a white peach right there. Probably yellow peach. This one is probably the white peach. I can't remember which. The smaller one isn't growing as fast as the white peach. And the plum tree. And then... God, there's iris everywhere. I just get way too many iris. Tons of chives, which I just kind of cut them down every once in a while just so you get fresh chives and then just let the other ones go grow up. And my daughter braids the blooms into head crowns. She braids them in a big loop. Anyway, I decided to run my snap peas, up these poles, and then I made a little goofy contraption up top to bring the poles together instead of tying them. I'll see how that works. This whole area is bush beans and onions that are left over from last year, and then new onions that we planted here. And over here we have a cucumber, and that's just a slicing cucumber. And this one is something called an Asian cucumber. I don't know what that's going to be. We'll see. And I don't know. I forgot what I planted here. This is acorn squash, and this, if it survives, will be butternut squash. Yay. Blueberries. So that's my garden, and I think what I'll do, well, in a month and a half when things are really going, then I'll show you more of that, because I know how interested you are, just completely enthralled. Oh, let me quickly show you my lilac bushes that are in full bloom. Oh gosh, look at all the blackberries. Just blackberries everywhere. Our backyard is just full of blackberries. Anyway, those are always nice when they come on, but I have to keep beating them back because they're taking over. So there's the white lilac. Makes the yard smell really nice. And there's the, I don't know, it's purple. I don't know what kind of lilac that is, but it's a lilac of some sort. And then some big red bush. Mm-hmm. So that is the journey through the backyard. It's time to get some lunch. Take a shower. Should take a shower, but then I got a barbecue later, and then I'm gonna smell like smoke. I hate barbecuing, but it's pork chops anyway. All right, that's all I got for you. Hope everybody's doing well, and take care, friends. And I almost forgot. Today, this miniature rose bloomed, and that clover behind it, I'm actually encouraging the clover to spread out through this area. Just the green clover, and then actually, there's some red clover to the left, which is hit or miss. It kind of, when it gets wet, it comes around, and then when it gets dry, it dries up. Anyway, but the flower is what I wanted to show you, because it's nice. It's really nice. Just bought those for my kids as a gift when they came back from Germany a few years ago, and once they were done, I planted them, and they're doing pretty good. There's supposed to be a red one in here somewhere, but it's not... Oh, this one's like yellow and red striped, and that's just yellow. No, the red one's not doing so good. Anyway, and I'm trying to fill this area up. This is a rhododendron. This is it's just a native rhododendron, so it isn't quite as big. And Oregon just has tons of rhododendrons. And there's our big one by the house that blooms every year. And I have to cut it way back to get some sun inside the house and by the where we eat dinner back there. My wife kills me when I chop it back, but it comes back like crazy every year. So I guess that's it. All right, that's it. I promise.